come together today, the invitation of Shane, Ruth, and Hannah Gregory to join the celebration of their marriage. Today, everything that you see and hear is truly just an expression of the deep inner love and joy that they both share for each other. On behalf of Shane and Hannah, we want to welcome you. You're here today as friends, family, loved ones. All of you have played a significant role in their lives. You've developed them, you've loved them, you've instilled wisdom and value in them. And so on behalf of Shane and Hannah, we truly are honored that you're here. You know, Jesus reminds us at the very beginning of creation that God created male and female for this type of moment, for these relationships. When God said, for this cause, a man shall leave his father and mother, be united with his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. Marriage is truly one of God's greatest gifts that he's created for our blessing and for the well-being of his creation. Not only did God ordain and set up marriage, but Jesus in his earthly ministry approved of it as well. It's commended in God's word to be honorable and beautiful among all people. God loves us. He's created us to love others. This is how he's wired us to truly be in relationship. Our lives find completion only when we love and are loved in return. Because together we can become what we never could be separate. And today, through the start of this marriage, you both are going to get to experience a side of God that you've never been able to experience. And let me tell you, it is going to be unbelievable. God truly leads us to our life's companions, and it's no doubt that he's brought you both here together for this moment. Marriage is a gift. It's a gift of God. So with that, it's not to be entered into without care or wisdom. It's not to be entered into casually without preparation. It's a sacred relationship that you both come together today to establish. So I want to remind you, as you stand before God, I want to remind you about your commitment to love one another that is essential for God's blessing in your marriage. I remind you to consider that you're making your promises today, not just in front of your friends and family, but also in front of God, who will also hold you accountable to uplifting these vows that you're about to say to each other. So with that, Shane, do you now desire to establish your home with Hannah as her husband, to receive her as your wife, to make a home where she will be loved and cared for as long as God grants her life? If so, say I do.
I do.
Hannah, do you now desire to establish your home as his wife, to receive him as your husband, to make a home where he will be loved and cared for as long as God grants him life? If so, say I do. With that, who is it that gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother.
Let's pray together. God, we are just so grateful to be in this moment. God, we thank you that you've created us not to live life alone, but to truly experience you in a deeper way through the loving relationship of marriage. So God, today we stand here at the beginning of Shane and Hannah's marriage, looking forward to the promises of what's to come. God, I pray that everyone in attendance today will know that we have a responsibility on behalf of Shane and Hannah to continue to love them, to continue to encourage them, to continue to be a voice when they need a voice and encouragement, when they desperately need encouragement, and maybe even a shoulder to cry on in those times. God, we know that this is what true community looks like, and we're grateful. We pray this in your name. Amen. Well, Shane and Hannah, I know that you both have been looking forward to this moment for a really long time. I mean, it is obvious by the beautiful decorations in the church that you've made all the preparations necessary to make sure that this day goes as smoothly as possible. But I want to remind you that no matter what happens today, no matter what little hiccups might come or go, let this sink in. At the end of the day, you're going to be married. So enjoy this time, enjoy these next few moments. And the way I want you to help with this is I want you to just take a big breath, exhale, there you go. Now let's have some fun. Shane, I've had the privilege of knowing you really over the last 3-4 years, and man, there are so many things that I could say that I truly admire about you and your friendship and who you are. But I have to tell you, the big thing that stands out really is something that I'm jealous of. And I've never shared this with you before, but Shane, you have this ability to carry nicknames wherever you go. Nicknames that I truly admire, like Country Man Singer or Shame Train from softball. Or maybe my personal favorite. It's not the Shame of Ruth that used to fear and intimidate people, but it was in fact the Suicide Kid in your wrestling days. And Shane, the fact that the Suicide Kid could get this beautiful, amazing woman to not only go out on a date with you, but then to actually fall in love is a true testimony of God's grace and His goodness and His love for us. You know, God has a unique way of bringing us together, doesn't He? Whether it's through meeting randomly, or being set up on a date, whether it's the internet, or love at first sight, or possibly, like your guys' situation, love at second sight. From what I understand, your first date was not only awkward, but left a lot of question marks. And we're glad that, you know, you guys decided to go on that second date. From what I heard, that was where you guys really established that relationship and knew that there was so much more. What you both shared is so unique. So unique. One of the things that I love about both of you is that you have a true desire for relationships, to be known, to be connected with other people. I love that because the most beautiful and meaningful values in life are found in relationships. I mean, we were created to be interconnected with other living beings through relationships. The most meaningful human relationship is found in marriage. I mean, no deeper one is known than a husband to his wife and a wife to her husband. And when you both are committed to keeping Jesus Christ at the center of your marriage, this bond forms that is unbreakable. It's able to withstand any of life's storms. So Shannon and I also know that you both have recently built a home. And that's exciting. And, you know, in these recent days after your honeymoon, you'll be moving things into your house. And I know you know this, but houses come in all different shapes and sizes and styles. And you can buy a house, but you can't buy a home. You know, a home is something that exists apart from whatever kind of house that you might have. A home is not only where you live, but it's how you live. And I think that's a beautiful picture of marriage. That's why I love what Paul says in Colossians chapter 3, verse 12. He says, "Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourself," here it is, "with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, patience, bear with each other, forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord has forgiven you. And over all these virtues, put on love, because love binds them all together in perfect unity." And Paul is really sharing some paramount things when it comes to marriage. He says things like we need to clothe ourselves with compassion, with kindness, patience, that we always need to live with a posture of forgiving one another, just as Christ has forgiven us. And I think it's because although there are so many beautiful things that are going to come in your marriage, there's also going to be the not so desirable. You know, things like dirty socks left out, the toilet seat not put in the right position, or maybe the deep need to want to be right at moments. It's in these moments that we got to remember, what am I going to clothe myself with so I can best love my spouse? That's why what the Apostle Paul says in verse 14 of Colossians is so key. He says, "Above everything, love. Love is what binds it together. Love is the virtue that we should put on that creates perfect unity." See, marriage is more than a contract. It's a mutual commitment to take the love that you have to go deeper and deeper. Deeper than momentary happiness, but deep into the discovery of who you most truly are. It's a commitment to a journey, to a life of becoming. Because of that, marriage is more than just that commitment. It's a covenant. A covenant says, "I love you, that I trust you, I'll be here for you. I'll be here for you when you're hurting. You'll be here for me when I'm hurting, and I'll never leave you." It's a covenant intended not to provide haven for pain or from anger and sorrow. I mean, life offers no such haven. Instead, marriage is meant to be a sanctuary where it's safe enough to risk loving, to risk living, to risk sharing life at the deepest parts of who you are. You know, the New Testament, the Apostle Paul also really indicates that true happiness in marriage comes by putting the other person first. And God gives a man a specific role in a marriage relationship, and He gives the wife a specific role. So with that, I want to read Ephesians chapter 5, verse 21. Paul says this out of the Message translation. He says, "Out of respect for Christ, be reverent to one another. Wives," so this is for you, Hannah, "wives, understand and support your husband in ways that show your support for Christ. The husband is to provide leadership in the way that Christ does to the church, not by domineering, but by cherishing. So that just as the church submits to Christ, as he exercises such leadership, wives should likewise submit to their husbands. Shane, this is for you. Husbands, I love this. Go all out in love for your wife, exactly as Christ did for the church. A love marked not by giving. I'm sorry, marked love by giving, not by getting. Christ's love makes the church whole. His words evoke her beauty. Everything he does and says is designed to bring the best out of her, dressing her in dazzling white silk, radiant with holiness. And that's how husbands are to love their wives. Wow, what a beautiful picture. You know, Shane and Hannah, God's writing an incredible story in and through your lives. I mean, the way that God's brought you together, the timing of everything, it is truly of God. And as we stand here today on day one, like I said earlier, we are all waiting in excitement with anticipation of what God's going to do in and through your lives together now as one. You know, Shane, I had the opportunity behind your back to ask Hannah what it was about the Shane Roof that wooed you into his arms. Shane, Hannah had some incredible things to say. She said things like, it was the fact that you have this amazing kind heart, your willingness to always help other people. Shane, Hannah loves that no matter what, she can be 100% herself. It's the little things, she said. It's the things that, the abilities that you have to make her laugh, the small little jokes that maybe no one else would get. And especially the moments when she's down, you know, to go to McDonald's and get the dollar ice cream sundaes. That truly mean so much to her. I guess another word is it's the little things that truly drew to you. Wow. Hannah, I was also able to ask Shane what it was about the Hannah Gregory that sort of stole this man's heart. I love what Shane had to say. He said this amongst many things. He said that you have this over-the-top ability to believe the best in people. I love that. Over-the-top ability to bring out the best and believe in people. Shane loves that you have a sweetness about you that is so refreshing. Shane loves the fact that you always seem to draw out the best in who he is. I mean, even after these few little things, it is, again, just more confirmation of how much you truly really love each other. And although there will be hiccups and there will be bumps in the road and those will be expected, if you guys remember this about keeping Christ first and this type of love, you guys are going to be able to stand strong. This is unique. The bond that you have is unbreakable as long as you remember to keep Christ first. Shane and Hannah, in light of your desire to enter into the binding covenant of marriage, I'm going to ask you now to share vows. Vows of commitment to each other, to God, to your friends and family today. So Shane, I'll start with you. You can look at your bride. Repeat after me. I, Shane, take you, Hannah, to be my lawfully wedded wife. To be my lawfully wedded wife. I got your back, Hannah. To have and to hold. To honor you. To treasure you. To be at your side in sorrow and in joy. In the good times and the bad. And to love and cherish you always. I promise you this from my heart. For all the days of my life. And I ask that you now repeat the same vows back again. Shane. I am. Take you, Shane. To be my lawfully wedded husband. To have and hold. To honor you. To treasure you. To be at your side in sorrow and in joy. In the good times and the bad. And to love and cherish you always. I promise you this from my heart. For all the days of my life. Shane and Hannah now have rings that signify the promises that they've just made. You know, these rings, though they are small in size, they are large in significance. A precious metal, they remind us that love's not cheap or common. Made in a circle, their design tells us that love should be continuous, never ending, but forever. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart, may they be that constant reminder of these promises that you both have. I've just made it for each other. So Shane, go ahead and put this on Hannah's ring finger. Would you repeat this after me, Shane? With this ring, I give to you my promise. That from this day forward, you shall not walk alone. May my heart be your shelter. And my arms be your home. May God bless you always. And may we walk together through all things. May you feel deeply loved. For indeed you are. May you always see your innocence in my eyes.
May you always see your innocence in my eyes.
And place that on your shins, remove your repeat this after me. With this ring, I give you my promise.
I give you my promise.
That from this day forward,
you shall not walk alone.
May my heart be your shelter.
May my heart be your shelter.
And my arms be your home.
May God bless you always.
May we walk together through all things. May you deeply feel loved. For indeed you are. May you always see your innocence in my eyes. Marriage is a gift of God. It's the clasping of hands and the blending of hearts, the union of two lives as one. The two candles that have been lit represent your lives at this moment. They are two distinct lights, each capable of going its own way. As you light the center candle here in a moment and extinguish your own, these two distinct lights will now merge into one, representing the new family that you both are creating today. So for this moment on, may your thoughts be for each other, not for yourself. May your plans be mutual, your joys and your sorrows shared. These symbols stand for the oneness and newness of your lives together. And remember to let this oneness and newness continue every day. Never let this get old. Especially, never let it become divided.
Thank you.
Shane and Hannah look forward to greeting all of you. They're excited about that. Right now, they're going to be getting photos taken, so we're going to do an open dismissal, and they look forward to seeing everybody at the Family Life Center. If you're not familiar with this church, it's directly across from the parking lot, and you're dismissed leaving this time. They look forward to seeing you here in a little bit. Thanks for coming.